Hi, I'm Kathy Amos, broker of record at Peak Professionals Realty. And today on Peak TV, we're here to talk to Netta Bolak about how to get your house ready for an open house. So Netta, thanks for coming out today.
Thank you.
What kind of advice do you have for people on that?
So as far as getting ready for showings or open houses, I always tell my clients to make sure before they leave the house to turn on the lights, open up all the curtains and the blinds, make sure that you're getting lots of natural light, and maybe open up a couple of windows actually to air out the home. If you happen to be making some cookies for the kids, bonus!
Cookies,
maybe for
the agent,
possibly. I would appreciate that.
Yeah, I think most agents would appreciate that.
Absolutely.
What about for an agent open house? What kind of things do you do differently for that, or do you?
No, pretty much the same thing. I mean, I don't mind if they don't turn on the lights because I'll go around and turn them on. But when they do it, they know exactly where each light switch is. You could have some that are hidden, so it's bonus if they turn it on and have the house ready. But same thing for agent open houses. The one thing I tell people for showings and public open houses is don't put any valuables out. You want to make sure that you know, that iPad that you used last night is tucked away, just because we can't always follow people around during the open houses. So valuables, put them away in a safe place so that we don't have to worry about it.
What about plug-ins or scented candles or things like that? Those things are like crazy popular right now, and I find them in a lot of houses.
It's a hard no on that. And as someone who suffers from migraines, I can't stand it myself. So imagine if a potential buyer came through the property and first thing they walked in, smelled all the strong smells. They could be pleasant, but it's still a strong smell. So I say, don't do it. It's just going to turn off buyers.
And what about cleaning? Some people sort of go crazy, get out the Mr. Clean. They're all over the place, like, you know, like a whirlwind. The house hasn't been cleaned in 3 years, but all of a sudden they're having an open house and today's the day they're going to clean everything. What about stuff like that?
So cleaning is actually essential. You want the house to look spotless and show ready, but don't take out that Javix in the morning and clean up, because that smell lingers on for at least a couple of days. So the deep clean, I would say do it a few days before and let the house air out and bake those cookies.
And no fish. Do not cook fish before you have showings.
Definitely
no, lots no of people fish. Do that.
Exactly. No fish, no smelly food.
No. Okay, any other tips that you think people could benefit from?
Good question. Just keep it as actually organized and decluttered. Actually, this goes back to prepping for showings. Decluttering is huge, and I tell people, think of it this way. You're moving, you're going to go to a new house. If there are items that you're going to move with you, but they're just making the space cluttered, pack them away in boxes, put them in your storage room, ready to move. If there are things that you've been thinking about getting rid of, like that ugly dish that you got at Christmas party, and you can't wait to get rid of it, This is the time to go ahead and donate it or whatever. Just get rid of it now. And it's going to make it easier to just have the place clean and decluttered, ready for show.
Right. Perfect. Okay. Well, thanks, Netta, for coming in. And if anybody has any questions further about this, then please feel free to contact Netta. We'll see you next time on Peak TV. Bye.
Bye.